So I got these sprites all rendering at different locations. I did some quick timings just to see where the cost was going. Updating the constant buffer was the bottleneck for the game thread, and the D3D draw indexed call was the bottleneck on the command buffer thread, the rendering command buffer thread. So that was just a quick look at just to get some rough ideas how long things were taking. The command buffer, the constant buffer update is slow because it does a mem copy to copy the data into the command buffer. So in future, might have to optimize that. And then the draw call is slow because I'm drawing 1,000 quads as individual draw calls, and I'm passing the data to D3D quite efficiently, so the bottleneck is the API, which in future I could get around that by using instance primitives or other sort of vertex buffer schemes to put out more quads like you would for a particle system or something, for example. But for the time being, I just got an idea in my head how long things were taking and what to look out for in future. And I was going to start getting these sprites to update their position. So I'm just starting to add the debug dynamic update function here, loop through number of entities, check if the entity has the component dynamic flag, and then if so, I'm just going to add some random update. So I got them moving then. A bit too quick at the moment. But just to get the pipeline in for updating and moving sprites and updating their constant buffers. Slowly, one bit at a time, building up the interfaces and functions I need to implement this behavior. Then I started to split them up into different functions so I could time the cost of each update component. And here are the times. I got 0.3 milliseconds for the debug update, 8 milliseconds for the constant buffer update, and consume command buffer was actually quite small because it does it every constant buffer update. And then I just added some code to spawn them back to the middle of the screen and give them a random direction when they go off the edge of the screen, just to sort of keep the update going and have a quick look at the times.